Well, today is the day that Mikhail Kalashnikov died. The guy who invented the AK-47. So, kind of in honor of him, I bought this Zastava M90, or M70, which isn't exactly a Kalashnikov rifle, but it is a copy of a Kalashnikov rifle. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this guy into a battlefield pickup. It's actually in really good shape. And, you know, I mean, you've seen 100 videos about these things, but the reason I like this one is because the wood stock really isn't finished very well. So, anything I do to it will soak right into the wood. And I'm going to, of course, you know, buff the finish up and make it all shiny. So, this is kind of an honor of Kalashnikov. You know, his device he created probably caused the deaths of a third of this world's population over the course of the last 60 or 70 years. 60 or so. You know, he said he never took any blame for it. He said, "I don't blame myself for inventing it. I blame the politicians for using it." So I'm going to do the best I can to beat this rifle up while making it still work pretty good. And we'll see how she goes here. Here's the rifle basically when it's done. I do want to darken the handguards up, but it looks a lot more battlefield damage because I took a lot of that bluing off. So the light really doesn't do it justice to how much less dark it is. It's all shiny like it's been polished up with some sand. I think it looks phenomenal. I'd like to get maybe a wood grip. I mean, the black grip is fine. I got no problems with it. But a wood grip would really make that that silver patina stand out. So I got this kind of in honor of Kalashnikov, and I set it up to look like a real Kalashnikov should. So there you go. There's the Zastava that I got. What I did was I took some Brillo pads and some vinegar, like some real vinegar, not cooking vinegar, which is acetic acid, and I just scrubbed it with Brillo pads and vinegar, and I think that looks great. So that's the basic overview of my battlefield pickup. I've always wanted to make one. And the Yugo is fairly affordable, so it's easy to do. And it's kind of cool to do it on the day that Kalashnikov died, even though this isn't a real Russian-endorsed one. I also like to take the buttstock off because I like the shortest length of pole possible on my AKs. I know it might not make sense, but I like it. And I think that worn out look, and I'm going to darken these stocks up a lot too, but, you know.